or D? Let's think of it as a C. You know, C is a character next to D. So you will be reminded that when you see this character, this is letter D. So for R, it's the same for R. It looks like letter S. But then, you have to think that S is next to R. So this character is R. And then this is M, the box. For B, B is like an inverted A. And then S is an inverted Y. For NG, a circle, and then a J is like an S with a horizontal line above it. And then for CH, we will just add a single stroke on the above of the horizontal line. And then for K, is an inverted F. For T, an E. And then for V, a Roman numeral 2. And then for H, H is like a hat on the head. And then for the vowels are easy. You start with the vertical ones. For A, you will add a short stroke on the right. For Ya, two double strokes on the right. For O, one stroke, one short stroke on the left. For Yo, two short strokes on the right, on the left. For O, one short stroke on above of the horizontal line. And then for Yo, two strokes above the horizontal line. For one stroke on below of the horizontal line. For U, two strokes below the horizontal line. For U, this is a straight line, straight horizontal line. And this for I, a straight vertical line. For the vowel combinations, this one is just a combination of the different vowels. We'll tackle about it later when we use it in words. Now let's start with the words, the WH questions. For what? What in Korean is small? And it is written in this way. For where is Audi? Audi is written in this form. Since this is, as you can see, when there is no consonant before the vowel, we will put a placeholder with this symbol. But if there is a consonant before the vowel, then it is okay not to use the placeholder anymore. For when? Onje. So this is written in this form. Onje. And then for how? This okay. Yeah.